Ketika kita berdoa memohon kepada Allah, ya Allah, ya Tuhanku, aku ingin mengenalmu, tapi bagaimana aku bisa mengenalmu kecuali hanya Engkau membukakan untuk aku bisa mengenalmu. Dengan ketidakberdayaan kita, dengan luluh lantak kita di hadapan Allah, dengan kekecilan kita yang tidak mengetahui apa-apa ini, kita memohon dan kita bertawadhu di hadapan Allah. Mudah-mudahan dengan jalan seperti ini kita akan dibukakan oleh Allah SWT untuk bisa mengenal dirinya yang Maha Agung dan Maha Besar. Dengan itu dikatakan man arafa nafsahu faqad arafa rabbahu. Siapa yang mengenal dirinya sendiri akan mengenal Allah SWT.
And Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala at that time reminds us of the model of human beings. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he tells us to go to my Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and follow him. If you claim that you love me, you want to come to me, you must follow him. You must love him.
Dan Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala mengajak kita untuk mengikuti Nabi Muhammad SAW. Di dalam Al-Quran dikatakan in kuntum tuhibbunallaha fattabi'uni. Dikatakan jika engkau mencintai aku, mencintai Allah, maka ikuti aku.
But even the way to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also, because when we start reflecting on the attributes of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we realize and we say, ya Rasulullah, who am I? How can I come to you with all my limitations and your greatness? And you are Ra'uf, you are Rahim, you are Rahmatan lil Alameen, you are Ar-Rahmat al-Muhdad, the gift offered of mercy to humankind, and you are the one of perfect manners and perfect character and attributes, the one who was invited on Isra and Mi'raj to Qaba Qawsain Yaw Adna, and we are stuck in dunya and we are not even accomplishing with the fard. We find difficulty, let alone the sunnah, let alone the adab. So we find it very difficult. And Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam says at that time, why don't you go to my inheritors? Why don't you go to the awliya that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put in your lives? Why don't you go to your murshid who has my amana for you? And at that time we are approaching, you see, the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are reminding us of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we are approaching the qualities and attributes of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the presence of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam through our murshid. So it all comes down in reality to understanding and knowing and keeping suhba, company, and following who? Our murshid, Maulana Sheikh.
Lalu beliau berdoa kepada Allah SWT dan mengatakan, ya Rasulullah SAW, engkaulah yang mulia, engkaulah rahmatan lil alamin, engkaulah yang sempurna akhlaknya, engkaulah yang diundang untuk Isra' Mi'raj, dan engkaulah yang mampu mencapai Ka'bah Qausaini, engkaulah yang punya makam yang tinggi. Tetapi siapakah aku ini? Aku ini tidak punya apa-apa, aku ini terputus, aku ini banyak keterbatasannya. Maka kalau kita tidak punya apa-apa seperti ini, kita ingat bahwa Sayyidina Muhammad SAW mengajak kita untuk mengikuti pewarisnya. Siapakah pewarisnya itu? Yaitu para ulama, para awliya Allah, para mursyid. Mursyid kita ini, ikutilah mursyid, bersama mursyid, bersuhbah bersama mursyid, mengikuti jalannya mursyid.
And as we mentioned in the previous talks, imagine yourself reading a book, and Allah is reading that book, and that book is your heart. And your murshid is saying to you, I am reading that book also. So watch out and be careful. If we are conscious of that, and even that is difficult enough, even that is causing us, bringing down our image of ourselves, that we are able to understand the asma wa sifat, and the asma Allah al-husna, or come to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam safe and sound. No, it's not easy. Even to come to our murshid is not easy. It is difficult, and it is strange, and a sign of our being beginners How easily we think that we can just pick ourselves up and go and visit our murshid like that without preparation. And even if he gives us one thing to do or to follow, and we find that difficult, and we might let years pass even without putting it into practice. These unfitness, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. May Allah forgive us, may Allah teach us, may Allah correct us, may Allah not punish us, but may Allah reform us, islah of ourselves and of our families. It begins with ourselves, and then hopefully spread to our families, our communities, like that. And when we make islah of what is in ourselves and tasheeh, then inshallah Allah will help us to help others. But we can never help others unless first we help ourselves. And we help ourselves inshallah by holding fast to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the hand of Mawlana Sheikh Nazim, who is the mirror of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our time, and the Khalifa of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our time. So the closer you are to Mawlana Sheikh with adab, with love, with following, with meditation, with obeying his advice, which is so practical, more palpable than the most concrete reality that you see, hear, feel, smell, touch, you know that this is real. It's not something that is beyond our power or our understanding. It is very, and he is coming to you all the time. So accept, follow, listen and obey. سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا وَفْرَانَكَ رَبَّنَا وَإِلَيْكَ الْمَصِيرِ. Safe and sound, inshallah.
Dan pesan akhir yang kita berikan untuk muhasabah kita pada akhir tahun ini adalah cobalah kita fahami tentang surat Al-Fatihah, khususnya tentang makna daripada Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alamin. Segala puji kepada Allah, Tuhan semesta alam. Dan Allah adalah Rabbul Alamin, Tuhan semesta alam. Apakah kitabnya, kata-katanya, kalamnya sudah dibawa untuk kita melakukan juga, untuk kita sebarkan kepada semesta alam? Dan juga apakah sunnah Rasul SAW yang dirahmatan lil alamin, sunnahnya sudah kita ikuti untuk dijalankan, diamalkan setiap harinya, tapi ternyata tidak, belum kita lakukan. Kita banyak mengikuti fitnah. Maka kita pada akhirnya kita mohon kepada Allah SWT agar kita bisa melakukan islah, agar kita bisa memperbaiki diri kita. Kita perbaiki diri kita sendiri yang lebih utama, baru kita perbaiki kepada yang lainnya. Bagaimana kita bisa memperbaiki yang lain kalau kita tidak memperbaiki diri kita sendiri? Lalu beliau katakan, berpegang eratlah kepada tali Allah. Dan tali Allah pada saat ini, tali kita yang harus kita pegang erat adalah Maulana Syekh Nazim. Kita pegang erat dan kita taati dan kita ikuti. Sami'na wa ato'na.